long ago, Vasudeva, a nobleman of the Yadava race, married Princess Devaki of Mathura. The wedding was celebrated with pomp and pageant. Now it was time for the bride and groom to leave her home. Devaki's cousin Prince Kamsa was driving the chariot. He was cruel and the people feared him. Recklessly he drove the chariot through the streets of Mathura, rudely scattering the people in his path. But Kamsa was enjoying the sight.
look at them run, Vasudeva.
Just then, a heavenly voice was heard.
Kamsa, you shall die soon. The eighth child born to Devaki will slay you.
The heavenly voice sent a chill through Kamsa's spine. Quickly he drew his sword and turned to Devaki.
If she lives to have that eighth child, I'll slay her before that!
Vasudeva leapt up to protect his newly wed wife.
Your sister has done you no harm, Kamsa. As for the children who are yet to be born, I shall give each one to you the moment it is born. I promise.
I shall spare Devaki. But I'll make sure you keep your word.
Kamsa confined Devaki and Vasudeva in a palace.
Go inside. Both of you are to stay here in this palace. You cannot come outside and no one may visit you. Soldiers, guard them well.
Yes, Your Highness.
Palace or jail.
Oh, what have we done to deserve this fate?
Don't cry, Devaki. Have faith. Have faith.
And so the time passed. Vasudeva and Devaki were overjoyed when their first child was born. But their happiness was short-lived.
Devaki! Devaki, give me the baby.
No, Kamsa.
Give me the baby or else I'll snatch it away. Like this.
Stop him. Stop him, my lord.
I can't. I'm helpless, Devaki. I gave my word to him.
Thus did the couple lose 6 of their children. When the 7th one was about to be born, Vasudeva and Devaki's joy was mixed with anxiety.
We must try and save this child, Devaki.
From that tyrant Kamsa? We will never succeed. Who will help us? Who will dare raise a finger against one who has imprisoned his own father?
Yes. King Ugrasena's plight is no better than ours. But Devaki, don't lose heart. Remember the prophecy.
And so time passed, and Devaki's 7th child was born. It was miraculously carried away to Rohini, Vasudeva's 2nd wife, staying in Gokul. Kamsa was told that the child was stillborn.
Good. The next will be the 8th one, the slayer of the mighty Kamsa. Pradyota. Keep a close watch on them.
Yes, my lord.
But as the months went by, Kamsa grew restless. Chanura, the court wrestler, sensed this.
Lord, why don't you come to the gymnasium?
No, Chanura. I'll be at peace only when I have killed the eighth child of Devaki.
It rained heavily on the eighth day of the waning moon of the month of Shravana.
Lord, I think the time has come.
The eighth child?
It was past midnight when the child was born.
Ah, what a beautiful baby he is. And he knows he must not cry. I long to hold my son. But these chains... Ah, look, the chains have fallen off. And the doors have opened. Devaki, quick, give the child to me. I'll take him to our friend Nanda in Gokul.
And Vasudeva walked past the guards who had fallen asleep, holding the newborn baby in a basket over his head. Gokul was on the opposite bank of the river Yamuna, which was then in spate.
How on earth will I get across these billowing waves?
But, to his surprise, as Vasudeva approached, the waters parted. Clutching his precious basket, Vasudeva walked across the bed of the river. As soon as he reached Gokul on the other bank, the river Yamuna was in full spate again. As he neared Nanda's house in Gokul,
ah, the cry of a newborn baby. It comes from Nanda's house. Nanda's wife, Yashodha, has had a child.
Vasudeva put the basket down and picked up Yashodha's child from the cradle.
It's a girl. Surely, Kamsa would not kill a baby girl.
So Vasudeva left his eighth child in Nanda's house and carried Nanda's baby girl to Mathura.
The guards are still asleep. The baby is quiet too.
As soon as Vasudeva entered the palace, the doors closed, and he found himself once again bound in chains. Minutes later, the lusty cry of a newborn woke the guards outside.
Huh? Did you hear that? It's the wail of a newborn baby.
Come, let's report this to the king.
The eighth child! I'll be there in a moment.
Kamsa reached the palace to claim the newborn baby.
No! No! Please, not again!
Spare the baby, Kamsa. What harm can a girl do to you?
Ignoring their pleas, Kamsa seized the baby by its legs and was about to dash it to the ground when it escaped from his hands, flew towards the sky, and a heavenly voice thundered.
The one who shall destroy you still lives.
Even as Kamsa was wondering where the eighth child of Devaki could be, there was great rejoicing in Gokul over the birth of Nanda's son.
Oh, Nanda's son is very beautiful.
Yes, and he has a beautiful name too. Krishna.
Krishna. Krishna. Krishna. Krishna.
Kamsa now set Vasudeva and Devaki free. However, he wanted to trace the eighth child. So he sent for the wicked Putana.
Putana.
Yes, my lord.
Go out and kill every child born in the month of Shravan.
I'll smear my breasts with poison and feed the babies.
Thus prepared, Putana set out on her search for newborn babies. Soon, she found a fond mother nursing her baby.
My little one, feed well, grow strong.
Ah, what a sweet baby. May I hold it?
My baby! What's happened to my baby? Where is Putana?
No!
And thus, Putana made her way to Gokul and saw a chubby little baby there.
Oh, what a handsome little boy. Oh, who is that boy? When was he born?
He is Krishna, the son of Nanda. He was born in the month of Shravan.
Aha. Now is the time when no one is around. Here, my precious. Here you are. Drink. Drink.
Yashoda came running out of her house on hearing the cry.
Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? I left him here. Have you seen Krishna?
No.
Have you seen my son? Oh, he's safe. But who is this woman? Why is she lying here?
I saw her nursing Krishna. Then she must be Putana. Putana the baby killer. She has killed many babies in Mathura.
She's dead. Putana is dead. The evil Putana is dead.
Oh, my Krishna. My dear little one.
Krishna was safe. And life in Gokul went on as before. As the years went by, Krishna grew to be an adorable little boy, beloved of all.
Krishna, Krishna, come. I have some fresh butter for you.
Krishna greedily ate up all the butter in the pot. But so fond was he of butter that he could never have enough of it.
Mother, may I have some more butter?
No, son. That's enough for today. Go and play with Balarama.
Balarama was Devaki's seventh son, looked after by Rohini in Mathura. the two boys ran out to meet their friends.
Come, Krishna. Let's go and play on the banks of the Yamuna.
Wait! I'll join you in a minute.
Krishna tiptoed into a nearby house, went straight to the pots of butter and began licking up all the butter. Suddenly, the lady of the house appeared.
You naughty boy, what have you done? Come, I'll take you to your mother right away. Yashoda, Krishna has eaten all the butter in my house.
My Krishna did that? I don't believe it. Why, I gave him a whole pot of butter only a short while ago.
But, sister, you must keep the milk and butter beyond the reach of children.
Taking Yashoda's advice, the women of Gokul began to hang the pots of butter high up on the ceilings of their houses. But Krishna and his friends were too clever for them. One day...
Let's steal some butter from this house.
The pot is very high. What shall we do now?
Shh! Quickly. Four of you bend down. Now you three stand on their shoulders. Let me climb on top of you.
There.
Climbing on each other's shoulders, the mischievous children managed to reach and break the pot of butter.
Come on, run!
Yeah!
Little Krishna's pranks grew. Yashoda found it difficult to handle the complaints that poured in.
Yashoda, Krishna was drinking milk straight from my cow.
But mother, the cow gave it to me. And the butter on your face? Who gave that to you?
Oh, that. The Gwala boy smeared it on my face. All out of spite.
Look, mother, I'm so short. And the butter pot is kept so high. How could I reach it?
Krishna, you're becoming naughtier day by day. I'll have to punish you. Come here at once.
I shall tie you to this heavy mortar so you cannot run around making mischief.
I'll go to Balarama. He'll surely untie me.
As he trudged through the forest in search of Balarama, dragging the heavy mortar effortlessly behind him, Krishna found himself stuck.
Oh, the mortar is caught between two trees.
To free himself, Krishna pulled with all his might till the huge trees crashed to the ground. As the news spread, a crowd gathered at the spot.
That boy is a marvel. He uprooted those two mighty trees.
There must be some magic here.
Yes, yes. Come, let us all leave Gokul and go to Vrindavan.
Yes, yes. Let's go.
Yeah, let's go. Let's go. Come on.
These strange happenings frightened the people. So, they decided to leave Gokul and go to Vrindavan.
Mother, may I go with the others to graze cattle?
You may,
if you stay by Balarama's side.
It's evening. Let's go home.
Krishna. We're too tired to herd the cattle.
Well then, I'll herd them from here.
Such lovely music.
Look, the flute's music has drawn the cows together.
Krishna is herding them by playing his flute.
Even the Gopikas stopped their chores to listen to the melodious strains of Krishna's flute.
Ah, his music fills me with a strange yearning.
One day, as Krishna and his friends were returning home, a fearsome bull blocked their way.
It's husband! Run, Krishna!
I won't! I'll tame him!
Please, come back, Krishna! He'll hurt you!
As Krishna neared him, the bull snorted fiercely and charged. But Krishna was too quick for him. Nimbly, he leapt on the back of the angry bull and patted him.
Quiet, my friend, quiet. I won't hurt you.
Much to the surprise of his friends, the raging bull turned calm and timid, like a lamb. Thus did Krishna firmly but gently calm the angry bull. One day, Krishna found one of his friends crying.
What is the matter? What is the matter? Why are you crying?
My cows are dead. They drank water from Kalia's pool.
Our cows will not be safe as long as Kalia lives.
Kalia was a poisonous snake who, with his family, lived in the pool. Krishna decided to confront him.
Krishna! Where are you going?
Krishna! Come back! Stop!
Krishna, what are you doing?
Krishna climbed a kadamba tree and jumped into the middle of the pool. His friends were very frightened. But Krishna didn't turn back.
Krishna has disappeared.
Run and tell Nanda.
As the news spread, people rushed to the pool. Yashoda was beside herself with grief.
Hey, Govinda!
Hey, Krishna!
Hey, Govinda!
Hey, Krishna!
Hey, Govinda!
Long live Krishna!
Hey, Govinda!
Hey, Krishna!
Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? My Krishna! Why did you jump into the pool? Why didn't you stop my Krishna? Krishna! Krishna!
The panic-stricken people of Vrindavan then saw a wonderful sight. Krishna was playing his flute and dancing on the hooves of a subdued Kalia.
Krishna!
Krishna ordered Kaliya to leave the pool with his family, and peace returned again to Vrindavan. Some days later, the people of Vrindavan were preparing to worship Indra when Krishna said,
"We worship Indra because we are afraid of him. We ought to worship Mount Govardhana, whom we love."
Krishna is right. Come, let us go.
Convinced by Krishna's words, the people of Vrindavan set out to worship Mount Govardhana. But while they were doing so,
"Oh, Indra is angry!
We shouldn't have worshipped Mount Govardhana.
What should we do now?"
"Don't worry, my people! Follow me!"
"Govardhana is moving!
Govardhana is moving!
Look! It is rising! Bring your cattle and take shelter! It is dry here! It's a miracle!
Krishna is holding the mighty Govardhana on his little finger!
Krishna sheltered his people for 7 days and seven nights by holding Mount Govardhana on his little finger until Indra's fury was spent. Soon, news of Krishna's extraordinary deeds reached Mathura and the cruel Kamsa.
"Pradyota, I hear the boy Krishna held the mighty Govardhana on his little finger."
So they say, my lord."
"You fool! Why is he still alive? Didn't I order you to have him killed, sir?"
"I have tried everything, my lord. Even the mad bull Arishta and the wild horse Keshi."
"Have it announced that in a fortnight I will perform the bull sacrifice and invite all, including Krishna. But you must see to it that he does not return alive."
"Yes, my lord."
When Pradyota left, Kamsa sent for Chanura, the ace wrestler.
"Chanura, if Krishna is not killed by Pradyota, challenge him to a match and don't let him escape alive."
"Yes, my lord."
Kamsa also summoned the chief of Mahouts, who looked after the royal elephants.
"Yes, lord."
"You will stand at the entrance of the Yagna hall. When Krishna comes there, see that your elephant tramples him to death."
"Yes, my lord."
Then Kamsa sent for the wise Akrura, a kinsman of Krishna.
"Akrura, I want the whole world to know of Krishna. Go personally and ask him to come to Mathura for the bow sacrifice."
"As you wish, my lord."
Akrura soon reached Vrindavan and Nanda's house.
"Nanda, you must permit Krishna to come to Mathura for the bow sacrifice."
"No, Akrura. I don't trust Kamsa. I will not send my son there."
When Akrura saw that Nanda was adamant, he told him the truth about Krishna.
"Nanda, Krishna is not your son. He is the son of Prince Vasudeva."
"I don't believe it. Krishna is my son."
Akrura then told them the story of Krishna's birth and how he was miraculously brought to Gokul.
Krishna, did you hear that? Akrura says, Devaki is your mother. I'm your mother, aren't I? You are my son, my Krishna."
"Don't be upset, mother. No matter what happens, I shall always look upon you as my mother. But I seek the permission of my elders to go to Mathura."
"Very good, my boy. The Yadava chiefs will see that no harm comes to you.
You may go, son, but beware of Kamsa.
The next morning, Krishna, accompanied by Balarama, left for Mathura.
Take care of yourselves, Krishna, Balarama. Come back soon. May God protect you.
Krishna! Come back soon!
As they neared the city of Mathura, Krishna got down from his cart and decided to walk into the city. On the way, a beautiful woman came and fell at his feet. She had a lovely face, but her back was humped.
Lord! Lord!
Rise, O woman. Why do you fall at my feet?
Look at Trivakra. Her humped back has straightened out.
A miracle!
He must be our savior.
The news spread and a crowd followed Krishna and Balarama to the gate of the Yagna Hall. At the entrance, Krishna met Pradyota.
Sir, I am Krishna. May I inspect the bow?
Certainly. Do step in.
So, this is Krishna. What a little boy.
It will be so easy to kill him.
Is this the bow? It doesn't look heavy.
But it is. Even the mighty wrestler Chanura cannot lift it.
I still don't believe it's that heavy. Let me see.
Krishna lifted the bow and broke it. The jubilant crowd rushed into the sacrificial hall.
Victory to Krishna! He is our savior! Krishna! Krishna! Krishna!
When Pradyota went to Kamsa with the news, he was livid with anger.
Krishna broke the bow, and you stood and watched him do it. You had orders to kill him, hadn't you? I ordered you to kill him, didn't I?
I know, my lord. But the large crowd that followed him was frightening.
The next morning, as Krishna approached the gates of the Yagna Hall, the chief of Mahouts, as ordered by Kamsa, was waiting with his strongest elephant. They both suddenly charged at Krishna.
Krishna, watch out!
An elephant!
The elephant seized Krishna and clasped him tightly in his trunk.
Hey! Put me down!
No!
Krishna has picked up the mighty elephant by his trunk and hurled him in the air.
The elephant is dead.
Victory to Lord Krishna. Praise be to Krishna.
Krishna! Krishna! Krishna!
Come, Balarama. Let's go inside the Yagna Hall.
Krishna and Balarama took their place in the arena where the games were being held. Inside the Yagna Hall, Chanura, the mightiest wrestler of the kingdom, was waiting for Krishna.
Krishna! Kamsa has heard much about your strength and valor. He has invited you to wrestle with me.
That's not fair! It's an honor, Chanura. I am ready.
Be careful, Krishna.
First, Mushtika will wrestle with your brother, Balarama.
I'm ready.
It's unfair of Kamsa to put this small boy against Mushtika.
He'll be killed!
But the crowd was in for a surprise. It was Balarama who killed Mushtika.
Look! Mushtika has lost!
He is dead! Yay!
Yeah!
Chanura stepped forward.
Are you ready, Krishna?
Chanura tried to crush Krishna in his mighty arms. But Krishna slipped away. Disappointed, Chanura rushed madly at him. But Krishna nimbly stepped aside and picked him up and dashed him to the ground. Kamsa ordered his soldiers to attack the Yadava chiefs. But Krishna was too fast for him. He rushed towards Kamsa and swiftly took away his sword. Then, throwing him to the ground, killed him. The crowd was stunned into silence. Krishna lifted the crown from Kamsa's head.
But what is Krishna doing?
Where is he going?
What is he going to do with Kamsa's crown?
Look, Lord Krishna is going to King Ugrasena.
Indeed, Krishna was walking towards King Ugrasena.
My lord.
Krishna.
I have brought you what rightfully belongs to you. Please accept this crown and rule your kingdom again.
May God bless you, Krishna.
Praise be to Lord Krishna! Krishna, Krishna! Krishna, Krishna! Krishna, Krishna! Krishna, Krishna! Krishna, Krishna!
And this was only the beginning. Krishna lived long to triumph over all evil. His great deeds are remembered to this day.